Night for his medical vacation. We wish him very well. We wish him quick recovery. But when he returns by next year, he will be going back to his village in Dara. The reason is simple. In 2014 and 2015, we thought that he had integrity and the ability to run this country. But what he has done to us is so pathetic that one of his ministers yesterday or 3 days ago confronted me on a radio station and he said 75% of this country, Nigerian youth, are inconsequential. So our rival in Abuja today is a consequential takeover of the federal capital territory. It's a consequential takeover of the 36 states of Nigeria. It's a consequential takeover of the West African region. It's a consequential takeover of Africa. And it is to restore the pride of the black man. That as a Nigerian youth, you should never have to graduate without a job. That you should never drive on the road that will kill you. And may you never meet a doctor that prescribes medicine that kills you. May you never be that president after 3 years who cannot complete a single kilometer of road. The only thing they have done for themselves and always do for themselves is always for themselves. They reconstructed the Abuja runway because the president will need it to be going for his frequent medical jamborees. That's the only thing they have done since they came to power.
That's the only thing they have done.
On February 14th, 2019. That is a day that also has a coincidence. It is going to be a day of Valentine for the Nigerian people. As for our students, we will never burden you again. It will never be a crime again to go to school in this country. And what we will do, we will invest heavily in education. And when you get we are working on it. We are working on it. What is delaying us?
Working God is a miracle. Working God is a Alpha and Omega. Is a miracle. Working God.
Let me tell you. Thank you very much. I also want to address all our workers, because I'm sure that a lot of our security agents here today, you are entitled to be paid with dignity.
Yes, sir.
And we have said that for every policeman, SSS, immigration, civil defense, that is protecting this country, your salary must not start less than 100,000. Let me explain. They have been saying that it is not possible to pay Nigerian workers 100,000 naira, which is small peanuts.
Yes.
But they have never said that it is wrong to pay a lazy senator 30 million naira. So what we are doing is we are redistributing wealth from the 1% lazy, burdensome, criminal, corrupt elite in this country to the Nigerian people. I'm taking over this movement. I just want myself to be the face of it. It is your movement.
Yes.
It is now in your hands.
Yes.
And I urge you to all get your PVC.
Yes.
The permanent voter's card. Yes. We have figured it out. I don't want to waste too much of your time here because I know it's hot. I want to thank you for coming. I invite you tomorrow to our town hall meeting at Dennis Hotel in Abuja. From the response we are getting from you guys, it seems that we might even have to change the venue because it's already getting too small. Everywhere we go, nobody is asking us about our religion anymore because they have used religion to divide us for too long. Nobody is asking us about our ethnicity because whether you are Igbo, Yoruba, Hausa, it doesn't matter. You will be hungry if you are hungry. If you don't have money, your being Igbo or Yoruba or Hausa or Ibibio doesn't save you.
Yes.
Malaria does not know your ethnicity.
Oh yes.
So, HIV.
Weather does not know.
Yes.
And when NEPA, whatever they call them, are taking off your electricity, they don't ask whether it's a Yoruba neighborhood or a Hausa neighborhood or Igbo neighborhood. Everything that they have been using to divide us has failed. And like I told the Minister of Miscommunication yesterday,
yes.
You must have watched the video. Yes, Minister of Miscommunication, Shitu, that by this time next year, we'll be the ones smiling. And they will not be smiling because it won't be funny anymore.
Amen.
I want to thank you once again. And we'll be heading into town now to strategize for tomorrow. If you are from Kaduna or Kano, we are also going to have town hall meetings in those places. When we are done with town hall meetings, to explain our programs and agenda to the Nigerian people, which they don't do, as you know them. They are too arrogant to do town hall meetings. They are relying on Ghana Must Go this time around. That's why they approved the other day $1 billion for purchase of arms to fight Boko Haram. The same Boko Haram that they said had been technically defeated. What they are doing is they want to technically enrich themselves and technically steal and use the money for the next election. But they will be shocked. They will be shocked in 2019. Money will fail them the way money failed Jonathan. It's bad.
Take it back.
Nigeria. Our water. Electricity. Our hospitals. Our schools. National Assembly. Everywhere.
Take it back.
Thank you.